I tell you, this crowd is making it so I can hardly hear my own voice. They are indeed raring to go. It's Game 4 of the World Series between the Cincinnati Reds and the Kansas City Royals. The crowd is ready to erupt as their guys get set to take the field. Let's join public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
And now your 2016 Kansas City Royals.
And briefly here, a glance at the two starters who will get the ball here in this one. A moment here to take a look at the Cincinnati Reds starting lineup in this one. Who's the one to watch, EK?
Well, one thing's for sure. They love what Mookie Betts brings to this offense. He's one of the best clutch hitters in baseball. If they can get guys on base ahead of him, they'll have a great chance to hang a crooked number on the board.
Mike Minor will be on the mound for Game 4. What do we need to know here, EK?
Well, Matty, in his last outing, he got hit around pretty well. Gave up 6 earned runs. Going to have to miss some bats in this one.
And with that, let's take a look at the defensive alignment for Kansas City. It's brought to us by Majestic. Any thoughts, Eric?
Well, guys, this defense is rock solid up the middle. They've got a Gold Glover at second base who is athletic, agile, and has range second to none.
Gene Segura will come forward now, and as you see by the numbers, he's off to a hot start here in the Fall Classic.
Yeah, and you know some guys just love being on that big stage, and he's been a big part of this ball club all season long, so it's no surprise to me that he swung a hot bat when it matters the most.
The first pitch of the night is looked at for ball one as we get underway right at 7:05 on the nose.
First pitch, 7:05.
Minor has his target. Here's the 1-0. Swing and a line drive. Foul. Takes this the other way to right. Now a reach, and he takes a tumble here, but hangs on for the first out.
Nice.
And let's check this one out again. Look at him stretch out for this thing, and then he's going to tuck into a nice little barrel roll at the end there. That was pretty sweet.
Here's Mookie Betts. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. Boy, and it's a good night for the old hot chocolate here. 46 degrees at game time. And here's his fastball for a called strike one, and he's hitting an even 90 on the gun. And set up behind the plate is Kenny Jansen, as you see the rest of the umpiring crew there.
Well, Matt, there is some feeling that Jansen can struggle occasionally with pitches on the corners. I've seen both hitters and pitchers be confused by his calls on the black at times, so we'll see if that shows up in this one.
See you later, Marcos.
Ready on 1-2. Hit hard but foul to the left, and they'll try it again. Smoke toward third. Oh, look at Franco in the dirt, and oh, he can't quite dig it out.
Well, this game can certainly humble you at times. I mean, he makes an A-plus play just to get a glove on the ball, but that throw completely misses its mark. So for all his efforts, he'll wind up getting hit with an error. Unfair.
And Stepping in now, Corey Dickerson. And a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. This one's hit deep out to left center field. Vaccaro racing back, but he won't get there as it lands just shy of the wall.
Around third and being waved on home.
And they're going to take a 1-0 lead as the run comes across to score.
Well, he gives this ball a pretty good ride. No shot to get this one as it's going to wind up hitting on the track and one hop in the wall out there. He's going to wind up pulling into second with an RBI double.
Edwin Encarnacion will stand in now for the first time, coming off, well, nothing short of a dynamic performance last time out.
Well, it makes you wonder how they're going to attack him here in this game. I would bet that they're a lot more cautious with him.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
Boy, it's so important to be able to strike first in a postseason game. Get that first run in, especially when you're the team playing on the road. Hopefully you can take a little life out of this big crowd.
The 0-1 pitch. Chopped foul right at home plate. One out and a runner on second base. Swing and a miss. Looked like the knuckle curve there, and that's out number two.
Man.
Well, you know when you get two strikes on you, you go into that protection mode up there at the plate. Let's see where this pitch winds up. Oh, yeah. That thing's nowhere near
yeah.
the strike zone. And that's
if
a
I
good
win this
job
game, I win
the
World Series,
for something
man.
He didn't really want to hit.
Well, it could be my last.
Here's Albert now. As he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls
and
a strike.
And you know, if you're going to challenge a guy up in the zone with a fastball, why not do it on the first pitch? A lot of times he's going to be taken anyway, and you just bought yourself a strike that you can now throw anything off of.
And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Has to be thinking strikeout here. Skied into straightaway right. After it is Brown. And that's the third out. Reds get a run in the inning on this RBI double. On to the bottom of the first at Kauffman Stadium. It's now 1-0 Reds. And with that, here's a look at the hometown Royals starting lineup card. How do they go about staying alive in this one, Steve?
You got to be swinging at good pitches. Avoid wasting at bats by going out of the strike zone on this guy.
Irvin Santana gets the ball with a world championship on the line. Eric, any thoughts?
Remember, guys, this is someone that will come at you with four different pitches. He'll change velocity. He'll go up and down. The break on the pitches makes it a real challenge for a hitter.
And with a quick breather here, let's take a look at the defense for the Cincinnati Reds. It's brought to us by Majestic. EK, what do you got?
Well, guys, Gene Segura, very good at the shortstop position. Besides being very athletic, Gene Segura also possesses one of the best arms at the shortstop position. Hopefully, we'll have a chance to see him display that great arm of his in this one.
Sammy Vaccaro is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down a strike. It's 0-1. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And he is cruising now. It's 0-2.
Yeah, he came with a little bit of a different look that time. This pitch is also in their knee high, and now they've got him behind in the count, 0-2.
Slider. Ooh, thought he had him, but it's 1-2. very weakly on the ground. And he set down, one away.
Batting second, the shortstop, Ian Desmond.
Ian Desmond will get his first opportunity here, and if you go by the numbers, it's been a disappointing start to this World Series for him so far.
Yeah, he really hasn't gotten on track, and I think you have to give some of that credit to good pitching. But he's really been a bit of a non-factor so far. Still time for him to turn it around, though.
The 1-0 delivery. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Bases are empty, one man out. Down the line, but this is a foul ball. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. And the slider gets him swinging, two gone. And with two away now, let's take another look at our playoff brackets. And of course, the question on everybody's mind, will we crown a champion here tonight? Michael Franco gets his first cuts now. The bases are empty, and there are two away here in the opening frame.
Yeah, nothing doing so far here. He kind of needs to put up a tough at-bat right here just to make this guy work a little bit.
And he lays off there, 1-0.
Yeah, and coming right off of that strikeout, he's got to be thinking he should be ahead of this next guy. That's a tough way to fall behind.
Not close. It's 2-0.
And you go back to the call on that very first pitch, how important that was. Now instead of a 1-1 count, you're at 2-0 with a really dangerous hitter up there.
3-0 now. You got to figure that that man right there would be more than happy to see this guy at the plate taking his swings with two out and nobody on all night long.
And so would the guy on the mound.
And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1. And a fastball misses there, ball four.
And that's not the first time he's had the bat taken out of his hands. You see right there, a lot of pitchers just said, hey, with an open base, forget about it. I'm going to let the next guy try to beat me.
Todd Frazier will dig in now, coming off one of the best offensive performances we've seen in a World Series game for quite some time.
Oh, really just a game for the ages there. He put on a one-man show, and you can bet he probably won't see the same kind of pitches that he saw last time out. He'll be a lot more careful when he's at the dish.
Into the seats, 0-1. Oh, and you talk about a pitcher getting the benefit of the doubt. That's low, but called the strike anyway. Nothing in two now.
Well, he's down 0-2 now, and he hasn't even seen the changeup yet. That could be the strikeout pitch of choice right here.
Froze him for strike three, and that retires the side. So no runs here, no hits, no errors, and one man left on. Second inning upcoming here in KC. The Reds are on top, 1-0.
Clearly a ball.
Charlie Blackmon makes his way to the plate. He'll get us started here in the top of the second.
You know, guys, I love a guy like this leading off an inning for you. He makes good contact, and he can run.
Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing and one. Ah. Fastball called for strike two.
And they may have found a location that they like right here. Two different pitches, both taken on the inside corner. And now they can go just about anywhere they want.
Hard hit ball to second. Cano fields it cleanly. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second.
Batting seven, third baseman, Nick Castellanos.
Nick Castellanos will dig in now, and he's picked the wrong time of year for his bat to go silent.
Yeah, just one hit in the series so far for him, and they're going to have to get more out of his bat. But he's got to make sure he doesn't press up there, or that average is going to continue to go south.
And he takes a cold strike, 0-1.
And if you're not careful, this is the kind of guy that can run off six scoreless innings against you from here out. So that first inning run isn't something you can bank on holding up.
Miner gets the sign, coming at him with the 0-1. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Brown will wait on it. And he's got it for out number two.
Batting eight. The catcher, number three, Derek Norris.
Derek Norris will stand in, and you see the numbers for the series so far. He's really been one of their unsung heroes.
Well, it seems like in just about every series, you get that one guy who really steps up, and he's been that guy so far.
Into the windup and the pitch. And he starts the number eight hitter with a strike, nothing in one.
And, you know, I think it's going to be important that when guys get their pitches, they take advantage. There it looked like he was taken all the way, and he may not get another pitch that catches that much of the plate.
Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
And you kind of get the sense that he's not really messing around out there too much. There hasn't been a whole lot of setting guys up here in this inning. He's just trying to get himself back into that dugout as fast as he can.
Lifted in the air out to right. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases.
Yeah, real good extension on the swing that time as he goes out and gets that ball. You'll see the right fielder's got no shot at this one as it's over his head and one hops the wall out there. That's going to allow him to coast into second with an easy double.
Standing in now, Everett Cabrera, as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing in one. Trying to bunt his way on base here, but this will roll foul. Pause and the 0-2. Oh, and he dusted him off the plate that time. Some mind games being played now. It's 1-2.
And even on 0-2, you don't want guys to get into a comfort level up there.
Runner in scoring position at second with two down. This one skied out toward right. Brown on the move. And that retires the side. Danger averted following the two-out double. Game four rolls along. We're back after this. Robinson Cano will stand in, and this pitching staff has kept his bat silent throughout the series so far.
Second baseman.
Yeah, just two hits for him so far, but you got to figure he's due. I don't think they're going to hold him down all series long.
First delivery to him on the way. Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one.
And he's probably not going to throw too many first pitch changeups. That's a pretty darn good call.
Off the plate and in. It's a ball and a strike.
And that's a pitch you have to lay off right there. That tight slider busting down and out of the zone. All that can do is tie up.
Ripped on the ground to first. Encarnacion takes this over himself to record the putout.
Batting sixth, center fielder, Andre Ethier.
Settling in now, Andre Ethier. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Here's a good fastball that time as Santana jumps ahead, nothing and one. Good change up there as he takes command 0-2. Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. One out, nobody on. That's inside and low. It's a ball and two strikes. Four pitches. Fast, slow, fast, slow. EK, you thinking fastball here?
It seems to fit the pattern, but you better not get too predictable out there. Guys will catch on quick.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. And he will make the play. Two away now.
Oh, you can definitely feel and tell that it's October out there. There's a little bit of moisture in the air. Here, this ball sounded pretty good off the bat, and you wonder if it would have been a different story if it was mid-July out there.
Tom Noonan will get a shot here, and he's looking to get off the schneid, hitless in the series so far.
And he's an important guy to get going. If they're going to have any chance in this series, you really need to start getting a little more involved.
And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
And here's a case on the mound where he's trying to sneak a first-pitch fastball by him. But he was having none of that at the plate. He just sends it right back where it came from.
Dominic Brown set to take his first cuts with a man at first and two away.
Yeah, and he's going to have to find a gap to give that man on first a chance to score.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. He's set. Here's the 0-1. And he misses with it. 1-1. Swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2.
Yeah, I think you have to ask yourself, was he trying to throw a fastball for a strike right there, or was he just trying to set me up for that changeup away?
Hit hard to short. Segura has it. He'll go to Everett for the force, and the side is retired. Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance. Yikes. Back with more of Game 4 on the show after this. Gene Segura will try it once more. He lined out to start the ball game.
Gene Segura.
Third inning starts with a slider that's looked at here for ball one. Showing bunt there, but he pulls back and it's 1-1. And the 1-1 is in the air now out to center. Ethier on the run. And that's the first out of the inning.
Now batting, the center fielder, Mookie Betts.
Mookie Betts.
Set to try it again at the plate. He reached on an error and then eventually scored last time up.
Yeah, still looking for his first hit of the game, so let's see if he can come through with that one right here.
And here's a fastball called for strike one. Bases are empty, one man out. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Minor into the windup. 0-2 pitch on its way. And certainly no offer at that one. It's 1-2.
Not a real good 0-2 there. You don't necessarily want it in the zone, but you do want to at least give him something to think about.
Slider, and look out. That's up in the danger zone.
And even though that's not intentional, as a hitter, you still hate to see that ball up around your eyes.
And a half-hearted attempt that time, but they'll say he broke the plane, and that's out number two.
Up next for Cincinnati.
You know, it seems like every time we check these out and show motion, it always looks like the bat breaks the plane. Look here, sure enough, I don't think he holds up in time. Looked to me like that was the right call.
Into the box, Corey Dickerson, as he's swinging first pitch and sends a line drive out to left center. And he dives to make a spectacular catch. What a play there to end the inning. Worth a second look here, as this is a beauty to end the inning. Game four rolls along. We're back after this. Hank Conger digs into the box in the bottom of inning number three.
Catcher, Hank Conger.
Here's Santana right back at it now as he jumps ahead of the leadoff man. It's 0-1. And he falls behind 0-2. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Shot toward second. A diving try, but he can't haul it in. It's through for a base hit.
You talk about a guy who's really stepped it up all throughout this postseason. Here's your man right here. He's on base again as he leads off the inning with a base hit.
Sammy Vaccaro will dig in again. He grounded out to start the home first. Here comes the first pitch. And this one's in the dirt. And he is safe at second base as the decision to move up pays off, and that'll likely be scored a wild pitch.
Well, as you guys well know, mistakes tend to get magnified here in the postseason, so we'll have to see if this free 90 feet winds up leading to a run.
Close play.
Fastball in there for a strike. 92 on the radar gun that time. And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. No one out with a runner at second. Swing and a little tapper. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
Well, that was a bad play.
Yeah, and you know, I don't think that was the right decision. I think he figured that since the ball didn't get too far away from him, that he'd have a better
get
shot.
On it and throw
but he
it right
underestimated
away.
The speed and the jump at second base, and they don't get him.
Here's the shortstop, Ian Desmond, as the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike.
Well, this pitching staff has done a pretty darn good job against him in this series.
Standing behind the bat.
Runners are at first and third with none out. high in the air out towards shallow right. Dickerson's there. He's there to make the catch.
Here
comes the runner from third
what the fuck is that?
And the run will score on the sacrifice fly as that'll square things at 1-1.
Third baseman, number 7.
Well, you knew this was definitely going to be close, and that turned out to be a pretty good throw home from out there in right field.
But it's
going to wind up being just a little too late to get his man.
Into the box now, Michael Franco. Pitch swung out and missed the throw. And no throw, as it turns out, as he takes second with ease. 0-1, here's the pitch. Hit on the ground to short. Segura fields it cleanly. On to first, and there were two down.
Well, that's just good pitching right there. Really ties him up with that fastball in on the hands. And he hits just a simple ground ball there for the easy out.
Coming to the plate now, Todd Frazier. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here.
Oh, and it's so important to take advantage of these kind of opportunities early in a ball game. It can change the entire complexion of the game if you can put the other guys on their heels right away.
First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Chop fouled at the plate, strike one. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Pretty well struck high and deep to left field. Blackmon going back. He makes the catch. What a play on the run to end the inning. So they pick up a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. We're through three full here in game number four. All tied at 1-1. Edwin Encarnacion is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth.
And this is a guy that can make a big change in this game with one swing of the bat because you know he has big-time power.
Miner's ready. First pitch on its way. Behind on that one. Now behind in the count, 0-1. Count and the pitch. Hit the other way out toward right field. He'll put it away without much trouble, and the leadoff man is retired here in the fourth. So with the fly out there coming on the fastball, seems like an appropriate time to check out our pitch speed comparison for these two starters. And both of these guys working in pretty much the same realm, just a 1 mile an hour differential from 94 down to 93 is the top speeds. Albert Pujols is next as he finds himself behind 0-1.
Well, he's thrown a first pitch strike to about 60% of the batters he's faced, so that's a pretty good percentage because we're into the middle innings right now.
One run, two hits, and no errors in the game for Cincinnati thus far. Just a bit late, and he's fallen behind 0-2. And that is swung on and missed. He's down on strikes, and the first two are retired here to begin inning number four.
Very quickly, five pitches and two outs here in the fourth. So those are the kind of innings you love to have if you plan on working deep into a ballgame.
Into the box now, Charlie Blackmon. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time. And that's dead center for strike one. Two out, nobody on. High in the air out to center field. Ethier's there. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Reds are down in order. On to the bottom of the fourth, tied 1-1. Robinson Cano is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
Second baseman.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Sends that one out of play for strike one. And that's in there as well, 0-2 now.
Yeah, that's in a great spot, too. Just hard, late movement working down and in.
And a wasted pitch there, 1-2.
Maybe a good opportunity here to show him a changeup, give him a different look.
Pulled the string on him, strike three swinging. And the throw is there to record the first out.
Yeah, a nice job behind the plate.
He wants it low, so he's got a good idea that this ball might be in the dirt, so he's able to smother it and then make the strong throw to first.
At the plate is Andre Ethier. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Segura to his left. He's there. Throw to first is in time to retire Ethier for out number two.
Nicely done there at short as you see him ranging to his left. He takes it on his forehand side and then flips it to first for the out.
In now, Tom Noonan. Here's a slider to start things out. Looked at for ball one.
Sometimes all it takes is just one call to go against you, like that one right there, and then you get yourself out of your own rhythm. You got to be able to put that behind you and move on.
That's inside, 2-0. Lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1.
Right back inside with a fastball. This time, he got the call.
That's 3-1
come
now.
On.
I think it's time to attack now because these guys haven't been in too many good hitters' counts. This is where you need to pounce.
And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner.
The right fielder, number 9, Dominic.
Dominic Brown will dig in now, hoping to perhaps make him pay for the two-out walk.
Yeah, nothing going on earlier in this inning, but a chance to make some noise right here. Those kind of walks often seem to come back and bite guys somehow.
And he'll take strike one on the fastball, registering at 93 that time. Runner aboard at first here with two gone in a 1-1 ball game. And it's quickly 0-2. The 0-2 home. Chop foul at the plate, and he stays alive, still 0-2. On its way, the 0-2 pitch. Might have jammed him a little there as this is softly hit and foul off to the left. Looking to put him away, here's the 0-2. And a check swing here, but he holds up far too late as it's strike three and the inning is over. Royals leave one. Fifth inning coming up, tied at one. Nick Castellanos will step in now to lead off the inning as his guys look to maybe break the rut they've been stuck in.
Yeah, and after that first inning, it's been all zeros since. And once he kind of got settled into that groove, he's been a difficult nut to crack.
And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike.
He's just cruising out there now. I'll tell you, this may turn into a game of first team to two wins.
And he makes good contact there, but this is going to find the stands foul down the right field line. swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Ethier sprinting after it, but he can't get there. This splits the outfielders and heads toward the wall. And a good bounce back from 0-2. It's a leadoff double.
I'll tell you, this guy has been something else in these playoffs. I mean, when it matters most, he's come up aces more times than not. And he delivers once again here with a ringing double. Man, he's fun to watch.
Riding into the box, Derek Norris. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Boy, he had a great at-bat last time up, and he'll look for another pitch he can drive right here.
Minor sets and delivers. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat, nothing and one. Hit out towards second. There's Cano. Spin throw gets him at first. The only play he had, and he made it a good one.
Well, I think he may have taken the tougher of two approaches right there. I think he did have time to square his shoulders and try to flip it to first that way. Instead, he chooses the much tougher spin throw, but he still manages to put that throw right on the money.
Standing in now, Everett Cabrera, standing in from the right side as he takes strike one. Gotta say, for a strikeout pitcher, not too many strikeouts here so far.
And he's in a big need of one right here. It would definitely come in handy.
Hoping to keep it tied, here it comes. And here's a ball hit in the air. Brown on the move. He's got it. A nice play there, two away. And they will tag him out at the plate. And that'll keep our ball game tied up as the inning is over.
Damn it.
None left for Cincinnati. Halfway home, all even at one apiece. Hank Conger comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the fifth.
Tied 1-1, but catcher Hank Conger. Probably should have held up on that.
And a good pitch on the inside corner for strike one.
Speed.
Fastball misses inside. It's even at one. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Chopped foul over towards the dugout. One and two, here it comes. Squared that one up just a little late. Off the plate that time and a little high. It's even at 2-2.
Ooh, there's a tough one to take right there on a 1-2 pitch, especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
Swing and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out, one away.
And this is where the scouting report really pays off. I mean, sometimes you just got to go looking for a soft spot in the guy's zone, and they found one there.
Stepping in now, Sammy Vaccaro. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Here's a fastball at the knees. Good spot, good pitch, and it's 0-2. And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away.
That's now three straight strikeouts going back to last inning. Whatever he's throwing, it's working up there.
Ian Desmond stands in looking to put the bat on the ball for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. First offering on its way. And a fastball's in there for strike one.
Boy, we're more than halfway through this game, and he's thrown a first pitch strike to 70% of the batters he's faced. So he's pitching very, very well right now.
On, could we see another strikeout here? It's 0-2 now.
And this is part of why he's had a lot of success so far. He's done a lot of work on the edges and stayed out of the middle of the strike zone.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. One run on three hits, one error so far for Kansas City. Swing, and he pops him up over toward foul territory. Encarnacion has got it, and the side is retired. So very nice work there by Santana, and it remains a one-all tie. Gene Segura will stride in as he'll lead things off here in the Cincinnati Six.
And guys, this is the guy you want leading off this inning. He's your leadoff man, so maybe he can get things started, set the table for a little bit of a rally.
Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Segura turns and goes to second. And a very quick start to the inning here. It's a first pitch double.
Oh, and a great way to kick off the inning here. That's going to get the go-ahead run to second base with that double. And you know, even though it's still the sixth, you'd love to find a way to grab that lead right now and hopefully just let your bullpen take it home from here.
Here's Mookie Betts. Hot shot on the ground is short. There is Desmond.
Did not.
One away.
Fucking Mookie.
Well, we talk about it a lot. Ideally, this should be to the right side of the infield. Maybe you give him a break because he's such a good hitter and he is a run producer, but I'll bet if you ask him, he'll wish he had a different approach in that at-bat.
He's not in time as he just gets in ahead of the throw.
And let's just train our camera on that runner leading off from second. He's watching that pitcher like a hawk. So once he sees that he's not paying attention to him, he just takes off. And the head first slide gets him into third just ahead of the throw.
The set and the 1-0 pitch. And a strike to even the count. 1-1. Not too many strikeouts on the ledger for him so far, but it hasn't really mattered.
Yeah, I think ideally you'd like to see him miss a few more bats, but as long as you're keeping guys off balance and you're letting your defense help you, you don't need to strike a ton of guys out to be successful.
He pulls this one into right. Brown is there. Let's see if they test it. And the runner stuck in a pickle between third base and home. And they'll put the tag on him between third and home.
Again.
And I don't know what he's thinking, but it's a double play, and the inning is over. Michael Franco gets things started here in the sixth over the hometown team.
Third baseman.
That's funny.
Franco.
And they'll start him with a fastball that misses
run.
Down and away for a ball. 1-0. In for a strike, it's 1-1. Santana gets the sign. Here's the 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Not the first time he's felt the squeeze tonight.
Yeah, he's looking in saying, what do I got to do to get a strike?
And now a right-hander's begun to loosen up in the Cincinnati bullpen. All even now, 2-2. Fly ball out toward left center field. On the move is Betts, but he won't have a play. This is down and into the gap. And he has started the home sixth with a leadoff double.
Well, it's never an easy task to have to start an inning by going through the 3, 4, 5 guys. Obviously, no exception here because he drills this ball and he's going to wind up at second with a leadoff double.
He's set. Here it comes. Todd Frazier stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
And you can tell, he's starting to get a little jumpy out there. He's got to take his time and really focus in on the glove.
In the dirt. Come on. It's 3-0 now. Green light here on 3-0.
Yeah, I want my run producer swinging the bat. It's my number 7 hitter? Probably not.
High in the air and deep to left center field. And that one is out of here. A 2-run shot that gives them the lead. A 2-run homer that time for Todd Frazier. Yeah. His 3rd home run of this series. And it's given the Royals a 3-1 lead.
Oh, and that's a little vindication here against his former team. You know, I don't think he was looking at this game like it was any other game. He wanted to come in here, make a statement, and that's a pretty good one right there.
The batter, second baseman, Robinson Cano.
Here's Robbie Cano now. As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. Throw on to first, so a good comeback there as he gets the first out of the inning.
Well, there's a look at his pitches by inning, and as you can see, he's hit 85 for the game now, so you have to think they're watching him pretty closely in that dugout.
Andre Ethier will try it again, 0-for-2 with a flyout and a ground ball thus far. And now the Reds are going to get the bullpen moving here, and it's a lefty and a right-hander up and throwing. Fastball in there for a called strike. Sent on the ground out to second. Cabrera takes it in. Throw gets him, 2 down.
Now batting, first baseman, Tom Noonan.
Into the box, Tom Noonan, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
And now he's hitting left-handed where he's a lot more comfortable over his career. He tends to make better contact from the left side, so I think he's happy to be over there.
Low with a fastball here, in the dirt even, hits ball 1. Down the third baseline. And that's through for another base hit. He'll make it 2-for-2 in this one.
The right fielder,
Dominic Brown, stands into the box. He's 0-for-2 so far in this one. Now time is called here as we'll get a trip to the mound. Here comes Brian Price now out of the Reds' dugout on his way to the mound. And it appears a change is on its way as that'll do it for Irvin Santana. Nate Jones will take over here with a runner at first and 2 gone in the inning.
Nate Jones.
Dominic Brown will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and 2 away.
Dominic Brown.
He'll hold off on the slider to start the at-bat. It's ball 1. A runner on first with 2 away. In there, and it's even at 1.
1-1.
Here it comes on 1-1. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. Castellanos is there and the side is retired. The Royals come up with a pair, however, on this 2-run home run. 4, 5, and 6 coming up to start the 7th. It's now 3-1 KC. Back here at Kauffman Stadium here in Kansas City. Game four is off to the seventh inning now, but before we get it started, let's check out our game summary to this point. Edwin Encarnacion will stand in to lead off the inning. Middle third of the lineup, 4, 5, and 6 as they try to get something going.
And this whole lineup's been pretty quiet all game long. Just the one run, that's it.
Action in that KC pen now as a right-hander's begun to loosen
good,
up.
Man, not bad.
Infield in the overshift here now.
If I was winning this game.
And he gets ahead here with the fastball.
Just
strike
gave
one.
Up a big home
for that
run.
Man right there, just the one run allowed. The question is, can he make that lead stand up?
Well, he hasn't shown too many signs of cracking so far. He's got the look of someone right now who's ready to go the distance.
Hits it high and deep.
Ooh,
out
that might
to
be
center
a homer.
Field.
Get up.
Ranging
get
back
up.
Is Ethier.
Yes.
Still ranging back.
Gone.
So a solo home run for Edwin Encarnacion. His fourth long ball of this series. And the Reds have cut this to a 3-2 game now.
And you know, the only way you're going to tie this guy up on the inner half is if you go up and in. And if you leave it belt high, he can handle that.
Your game's not working.
He handled that one all right.
Here's Albert now.
Albert Pujols.
Lifted in the air out to right. Brown is after it. And that'll get down out there near the wall. Around first, Pujols on his way to second now. And he'll get in there easily as the tying runs at second now with nobody out.
Now batting. Left fielder.
Oh boy.
Charlie.
No outs.
Now here comes Kansas City manager Ned Yost making that slow walk to the mound. And that'll be all now for Mike Minor. So as he departs, he can't lose this ball game, but he is responsible for the runner at second, meaning it'd be a no decision if that run comes across to score.
Call for, dude. You just gave up.
Darren O'Day will come on now as he'll take over in inning number 7.
Number 56, Darren O'Day.
So striding in, Charlie Blackmon, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield.
I'm glad it worked, man.
Watches a fastball right there for strike one.
So often, playoff baseball comes down to the bullpen, and this is going to be a bullpen game from here on out.
In the air out to right. Brown is in pursuit and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first down. And he'll make it up to third safely here with one away.
And this will wind up working like a sacrifice bunt as the tying run's able to tag up and move to third now with only one away.
So stepping in, Nick Castellanos, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Trying to hold the lead. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
You know, a lot of times with a sinker baller out there, you're just conditioned to always look for something down. So he can surprise you with that high fastball, maybe four-seam it every once in a while. And when he does, he can forget it.
Steven Sung will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot. One out and a runner on third. And he starts to go after it. Question was, did he hold up in time? Yes, indeed, says the third base umpire. 1-1, here it is. The short hit hard. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. They'll cash in here as the run is in to score from
third.
Tied
it up, baby.
It's a 3-3 game.
The catcher. Here's a situation where he's probably keeping at least one eye on that runner at third base to see if he's breaking or not. But once he bobbles this thing, it's all academic from there.
It's a good game.
Derek Norris steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. And here's a fastball called for strike one.
Oh, that's a good fastball right there. And you had to figure that he was looking for that sinker.
Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2. Two quick strikes, and now the 0-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
And you know, as a hitter, with the runner at first and one out, I think I'm going to see something down in the zone because I know they want me to hit into a double play. Instead, they go ahead and they challenge him up, and I don't think he was expecting it.
Into the box now, Everett Cabrera. Bunt attempt with two outs. And the throw is too late. He's on with a beautifully placed bunt single.
Hey, you know what? When you've got a hit streak going, a hit's a hit. It doesn't matter whether it's a line drive, an infield chopper, or a bunt like this. They all get the job done, and they all count. That'll keep it going for one more game.
Gene Segura gets a shot now with two men on and two away here in inning number seven.
And we'll see here if he can come through. It can be discouraging to see opportunities like this late in a ball game go untapped.
And a fastball is in there for strike one. Two down, runners at first and second. Hit hard toward the right side.
Go, baby. Go, go, go.
For extra bases, is that on a plate to go ahead run and maybe another? And the run is in the score from second.
Oh, that's a big at bat right there. He gets a good pitch that he can handle. And boy, does he put a charge into this one. And that's going to wind up plating the go ahead run as he's into second base with an RBI double.
Mookie Betts will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
He had a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances, but he could make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
Side target here, and he hits it for strike one.
Boy, they've done a really good job against this guy so far. And it's the first time in the series that they've held him without a hit.
Looking to keep this a one-run game. Oh. They couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane to the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike.
That's sidearm, man.
Tap foul at home plate. Three runs already home here. High in the air and deep to straightaway left.
See you later.
Vaccaro looking up. Gone.
Yes! Blew it open.
Three-run blast to straightaway left, his second home run of the series, as it is now 7-3.
And that is gonna hurt. They've been waiting for that one hit with runners on base, and And that could very well be the one that winds up sealing the deal. That's going to make this a four-run ball game.
Brian Shaw will get the ball here as he looks to get the final out in the top of the seventh. Shaw. Into the box, Corey Dickerson. Now a little pop-up off toward the third base side. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Here's the 0-1 pitch. That's in there. And he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. I think that man right there is reaching the end of his wits.
His team is absolutely imploding right now, and it basically came out of nowhere.
Line drive to left. Vaccaro is there, and he puts it away to stop the bleeding. But they managed to bat around as nine men come to the plate and six of them score. Getting late. Stretch time now in Kansas City. The Reds lead it 7-3.
Big inning.
Steven Sung is going to go ahead and stay in the ball game and play third now.
Now playing third base, number 32.
Hank Conger will lead things off now in a completely different ball game since the last time these guys took their hats.
And after that six-run inning, you got to hope that you can put together some kind of response. The last thing you want to do is a 1-2-3 inning, so a little patience wouldn't be the worst thing in the world.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Chopped in front of home plate. Norris scoops it up, and he's retired here, one away.
Now batting, left fielder, Sammy Vaccaro.
Sammy Vaccaro gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Off the plate and low here, ball one.
Well, you know, if there's anybody in this lineup capable of getting a rally started, this is the guy right here.
And that's right there, and we're even at one.
One ball, one strike.
Bat explodes as this is popped up.
But you take a swing at a pitch like that, you're lucky that you only got sawed off. He's going to have to go find himself another piece of lumber.
And the slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. Liner towards second, but there to take this one is the second baseman, and that's out number two.
Well, that's a tough part of this game right here. You do everything right and get donuts. Absolutely nothing for it. You see, he goes with the pitch well, drives it the other way, but it's directly to the second baseman. He barely has to move.
Here's the shortstop, Ian Desmond. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Credit where credit's due. This guy's done a good job out of the bullpen.
No question. He's been able to hold that lead, and these guys really haven't threatened him at all.
Swing and a liner, but foul. Here's the 0-2. Sinking line drive out to right center. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
Let's watch this swing and show motion. You're going to see this pitch just tie him up in knots, but somehow he's able to fist it all the way out to right field.
First pitch of the at-bat. The fastball here is he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. Pitch to the plate is a slider for a strike, and it's all knotted up at 1-1. swing and a ball line hard towards short. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. One left for Kansas City. They're down four. It's 7-3. Edwin Encarnacion will stand in to try it again, already with one home run in the ballgame. And on cue, there it was, back in the seventh inning, a solo shot that provided quite a spark for these guys. Now a ball hit hard toward first. And the eighth will start with a bang, as this should be extra bases. For second is Encarnacion. And he'll get in there standing up with a leadoff double.
Boy, I'll tell you what. He went down and beat a good pitch right there. This thing is right on the knees, maybe even a little below the knees, but he still went down and got it. And he pulls into second with two bases. That is some sweet hit.
Albert Pujols steps in here. He'll look to keep it going after hitting a double and scoring a run last time up.
And remember, he jumped all over that first pitch, so don't be surprised if he does it here again.
In there at the knees, strike one. And this might advance the runner as it's on the ground to second. Throw on to first by Cano, and there's the first out of the inning.
Well, and that's just a really nice job right there. After the leadoff double, I don't care who the next guy is, he has to, at the very least, make a productive out. And that's a good job right there as he gets his man to third, now with just one out.
From the stretch. And he swings on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. A man at third with one away. Here's a ball lined into left center field, and it's going to get down for a base hit. And they'll extend their lead even further as the runs in to score from third. It's an 8-3 ball game.
Just a line drive right back where it came from. He was all over that one, and that'll get that runner in for third base.
Steven Sung steps in with one in, one out, and one on here in the inning.
Yeah, it's been a pretty good inning here so far, so we'll see if they can scratch another run across right here.
Good bite to the slider, and he takes strike one. Looks like he employed the slide step on that last pitch.
Well, maybe you see a little cat and mouse game going between the pitcher and the runner right now. We'll see who wins this duel.
Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit. Runners on first with one down. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline. But a foul ball, 1-2 now. Hit well on the ground to first. Desmond for one. Back to the pitcher covering. It's a double play, and the inning is over. It's a run on two hits here for Cincinnati. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. It's the Reds 8 and the Royals 3. Todd Frazier will stand in now to lead things off, and he'll do so with the same pitcher still out there. Seems he's earned himself another inning.
I think that's a definite vote of confidence, but he's done a nice job since coming in, so you might as well ride that hot hand.
Swung on and missed. It's 0-1.
And that's exactly where you want to put that thing. Start it right down the middle and trust that its action will cause it to drop.
And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Good action on the two-seamer there, and it's one and two. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at two and two. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2. Waiting on deck here is Robinson Cano. And this is taken here for ball four. So the leadoff man's on base to kick off the home eighth.
Hey, you know what? That's all right. He gave him a pretty good battle up there, and he never gave in to him. A walk you can work around. A home run, you can't.
Robinson Cano stands into the box. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. This is skied into short left center. Blackman is under it. He's got it one away.
Yeah, that's just a low fastball here on the outside corner. You see him try to drive the ball the other way, but he got under it just a little bit too much, and that becomes an easy flyout.
At the plate is Andre Ethier as he takes a called strike at the knees. It's 0-1.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're going to want to mix their spots here.
Grounded up the first baseline, but this will get foul for strike two. And now a swing and a miss as Ethier becomes a strikeout victim here. Two away.
Well, I would think he was due just to pitch an inning or so, but he's pitching pretty darn well, so why not stretch him out a bit? Been working so far.
Tom Noonan digs in, coming off a single in his last at-bat. First pitch on its way. He'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one. One 0 pitch is a sinker swung on and missed, 1-1. Two out with the man at first. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Swing and a liner. Foul. Two and two count. Here it comes.
Come on.
This one misses, and that'll fill the count here. 3-2 with two away.
And now 3-2, two out. He'll be helped by the fact that that runner will get a head start out there.
Goes the other way with it as this is in the air down the line in left. And Blackman will make the catch here, and that ends the inning. Royals leave one. Can't make any headway into an 8-3 deficit. Beautiful Union Station lit up here in Kansas City tonight as we're set for the remainder of this one from the K. Hector Neris come on now to start the ninth inning as he looks to keep this deficit right where it is for the bottom of the ninth. Derek Norris gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point.
Derek Norris.
And this is fouled back and out of play. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Now the one strike pitch is sent on the ground to Cano at second base. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
Second baseman, Everett Cabrera.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Everett Cabrera will swing it from the left side right here.
And you know, guys, he's not quite as successful when he's batting left-handed in general. He tends to have more success from the other side.
Splitter here, and it's taken for strike one. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Vaccaro is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two.
The batter, number two, shortstop, Gene Segura.
Digging in, Gene Segura. Already two for two. He'll look to add on right here. He slaps that one away, and the count will be nothing and one. Bases are empty here with two men out. To first, Noonan is there, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Reds, but they lead it by a count of 8-3. Dominic Brown will be the one to start things off with his guys in need of a ninth inning rally here if they're going to force a game five.
Dominic Brown.
In there, strike one. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. A lot of movement that time. It's 0-2.
Oh, you like the way this guy is just going about his business here. He's got a big lead, but he's pitching like it's a tie game here in the ninth.
And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone.
Two more outs.
If you can locate that pitch with movement on the inside corner, nobody's touching that thing. I mean, that's as good as it gets right there.
Here's Hank Conger. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. One out, nobody on. Line toward the alley in left center, and that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
You talk about getting the bat head out in front. This is rifled up the middle. Can't square up a baseball any better than that.
In now, Sammy Vaccaro. As the first pitch to him is taken low and away for ball one.
That changeup away is his ground ball pitch. That's a good job to hold off.
Slapped hard the opposite way. Dickerson is there, and there are two men gone now.
Well, that's a good idea right there. He goes with the pitch. He's not trying to pull it. Shoots this thing the other way. Just happens to be right at the right
baby,
field.
One more.
Ian Desmond will stand in, and their season hangs in the balance here as they're down to their final out.
In all the playoffs.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Grounded to the right.
Oh, God.
And it's through for a base hit, his second of the ballgame.
Making it difficult.
Let's train our show motion camera on that runner at first base. Well, here, he might have had a shot to get around to third, but you see him have to hold up to make sure the baseball doesn't hit him. And by the time he gets going again, he knows he'll have to hold on at second base.
Michael Franco will stand in now, and hey, give these guys credit. They're not going down without a fight.
I'll tell you what, they're not too far away from making a game out of this one after all.
Swing and a ground ball. This could do it. And the Cincinnati Reds are back on top of the baseball world. They've won the World Series.
Yes, baby. World Series champ.
And you know what? I bet the only thing they wish they could have done a little bit differently is win this thing in front of their home crowd. But you know what? I don't think anyone's complaining about that right now. They are a very deserving world championship club, and congratulations to the entire organization.
Back now on the show. It's all over, and you see the reactions there to the final out. And down on the field, we'll get a chance to watch the presentation of the Commissioner's Trophy to the new world champs.
Final line score for our ball game tonight for the victorious Cincinnati Reds, 8 runs on 11 hits.
Betts got MVP. Steven Sung got World Series MVP. Nice, dude. The rookie. Cy Young. Retired. Rodney retired. Big Poppy retired. Bartolo Colon. Yui Hara. Dickey Suzuki, Marlon Byrd, Cliff Lee, Kaczynski, nice.